Enklu Cloud is a collaborative cloud-based content creation tool that allows you to easily build XR experiences. With Enklu Cloud, you can create everything from location-based entertainment to training simulations for complex tasks. To start, let's go to the My Experiences page. The My Experiences page contains all the experiences you've either created or been added to. You can create a new experience by navigating to the Start a New Experience section at the top of the screen and clicking the plus button. You should then see a quick loading screen and be redirected to the web editor. After a little bit of time, the scene inside your canvas view should load in, allowing you to start creating your experience. If you'd like, you can rename your experience in the right tab of the screen, as well as add a description. To begin crafting our scene, we'll first navigate to the Hierarchy tab on the left side of the screen. The Hierarchy tab allows us to group and organize elements in our scene, as well as hide or lock the position of individual or multiple assets. If you've used the layer system from Figma or Photoshop, the Hierarchy tab should feel pretty familiar. Let's start by creating an empty asset in the Hierarchy. You'll notice there's already a group in the Hierarchy for lighting, but we'll be ignoring that for now. Click on the box with your experience's name and click on the three dots at the right. Select Create, and then select Asset. A new box should then show up under our lighting group with a default name of Asset. If we look to the right side of the screen, we'll see a field for editing the name and adding a description for our asset, as well as a box that says, drop an asset here. This is the inspector, a context-specific window where you can adjust different parameters of an element, like position or rotation, and also add scripts. Since we want to start populating our scene, let's find a cool asset from Enklu's public asset library. To access the public assets, navigate to the bottom section of the screen and click on the tab that says Assets. On the sidebar of this tab, we'll find a category called Public. Clicking it, we will start to see a ton of assets populating the Asset tab. From my experience, I want to create something with a space theme. I could scroll through the assets here to find a relevant model, but instead, I'll navigate over to the search bar labeled Filter and search Space. Doing so instantly brings up assets relevant to the kind of experience I want to create. I like the Arcus model, so to bring it into my canvas, I will simply drag the model back over to the inspector into the box labeled Drop an Asset Here. Once that's done, the asset in the Hierarchy renames itself to Arcus, and I can see its thumbnail in the inspector. If I decide I no longer want to use this model, I can simply hit the X button on the thumbnail and replace it with another asset from the public asset library. If you'd like to use your own assets for your experience rather than our publicly available ones, navigate once again to the Assets tab and click on the plus button under Filter. This will change the bottom window, showing a box that says Drop Files Here. You can either click on the Select Files button or simply drag a file you'd like to upload into this box, like what we did earlier with the inspector. In my case, I want to upload this asset of a moon, so I'll drag it from my file browser into the box. If you have more than one asset you'd like to use, you can select multiple of them in your file browser and drag them in as well. Enklu Cloud currently supports most major file formats like FBX and OBJ, as well as a host of common CAD formats. For more information about what kind of files we support, as well as file size recommendations, check out the Assets section of our documentation. You should now see a small thumbnail of your asset in the bottom window, along with its file name. If you accidentally attempted to upload an asset you don't want in your scene, simply click the X button to get rid of it. Finally, to bring this asset into your scene, scroll down and hit the Upload button. You should see a short message that says Uploading and be returned to the asset browser. Once the import is complete, a green box in the bottom left corner of your screen should appear that says Import Complete. Depending on the size of the asset, it may take a minute or so for your asset to be uploaded to the web editor, so don't worry if you don't see an import confirmation message immediately. Let's add a few more assets here in the hierarchy to round out our scene. Now that we have a few more assets to play with, let's begin to mold our experience here in the canvas. The canvas occupies the middle view of the web editor and acts as a preview of your experience before you view it on your preferred device. You can also directly manipulate your scene from inside the canvas as well. To move around the canvas, hold down right-click and press WASD to move forward, backward, left, and right. Additionally, while still holding right-click, pressing Q or E will move you up and down, respectively. If you're using a mouse, scrolling in and out will zoom in and out of the scene. Holding the scroll wheel will also allow you to pan the camera. Now that we have an idea of how to move around in the canvas, let's briefly go over how to adjust assets in the scene. You can select an asset you'd like to modify either by clicking on it in the hierarchy or by clicking on it in the scene. This will highlight an asset as well as bring up a movement gizmo. By default, this movement gizmo is a transform gizmo, allowing you to move an asset up, down, left, right, and backwards and forwards. There are two other gizmos you can use to edit your asset, rotate and scale. You can access all of these gizmos in the window on top of the canvas browser. If we click on the rotate tool, the movement gizmo will then change to allow us to edit the rotation of our asset on multiple axes. If we click on the scale tool, the movement gizmo again will change to allow us to scale our asset on the X, Y, or Z axes, or to increase its scale uniformly on all axes. Using the assets that are currently in the scene, I'm going to reposition them using these gizmos to create a cool sci-fi diorama. And finished. To make our scene just a little bit less static, let's add some public scripts to make our moon asset here orbit around Arcus. To do so, we'll navigate to the bottom and click on the Scripts tab next to the Assets tab. Like with the Asset Browser, we'll scroll down to the Public category, which will then instantly bring up a list of scripts I can use. Since I want my moon to orbit Arcus, I will select my moon asset in the hierarchy. In the Inspector tab, under Scripts, there will be another box labeled Drop a Script Here. Returning to the Scripts tab, I will now drag the Orbit script over to this box in the Inspector. Almost instantly, our moon asset will now begin to orbit Arcus. If I want to edit the speed and distance of its orbit, I can adjust those parameters in the Inspector by navigating to the Variables tab next to the Scripts tab. And that's it! We've now created a cool sci-fi experience in 10 minutes using assets from both the public library and our own personal collection, and added a little bit of scripting for additional effect. In our next tutorial, we'll show you how to view this scene in either your HoloLens 2 or Oculus Quest. You'll be able to witness the power of Enklu Cloud firsthand as we edit this scene in real time while viewing it on your headset of choice. If you'd like to take a deeper dive into the web editor or have any other questions about the platform, feel free to check out our documentation here. You can access the help docs by either clicking the help button here in the editor or by clicking the link in the description of this video. Have a great day, and we look forward to seeing you in part 2.